Well, God, we bless you. We thank you for all that has happened this weekend. God, we lift our hands and give you glory for all that has happened this weekend. For the souls that have been saved. God, for the things that you have grown in us. For the relationships that have been built. Be glory, majesty, dominion, and everybody shout power. Both now and forevermore. And the people of God said together, hallelujah, hallelujah, and amen. Come on, bless God. Be safe as you travel back. Hallelujah.
Yeah. my faith. It's so funny. People think good deeds will get you to the gates. But these same good deeds that have you burning in one place. But back to the story. Here's my pet peeves. Traffic, disrespect, and girls with bad weeds. These dudes are straight. These dudes are straight. Talking on that gunplay. Walk in my shoes, not stress. I'll see you on Sunday. I'm a blessed individual that shows the due right. I'm not perfect at all times, but yeah, I'm doing alright. I hope by now we can say that we're at least cool. Welcome to Gospel Hip Hop. It was good to meet you.
About you. Just for the mere fact, you could be in this type of environment, having this type of fun, and nothing bad went down. It's evident that God has not passed you by. So right now, with your eyes closed, I just want you to start to think about the places in your life where you know for a fact that God did not pass you by. Yeah. Just think. Some folk not far from your age, they were in their grandmother's backyard in Sacramento, California, and they were gunned down to death by the police officers. Shot at 20 times. But you're still here. He didn't pass you by. Some folk were on a bus trip with their school this year. Y'all seen the news and the bus flipped off of a bridge. But your bus, your car, your church van, yeah, made it to the mountain. Did not pass you by. And so when we're in settings like this, we're in environments like this, we have to remember and keep our minds focused on the fact that the reason that we have the power that God says we have, the reason that we can function in the power that Paul is telling Timothy he has, is because we serve a God that refuses to pass us by. So right where you are.
No, seriously, we have a responsibility to empower. To empower. And in years, when they do, if they do, the autopsy of a dead generation, I think the first thing that they're going to find on the list is that the generation before them failed to speak power into them. Cause of death, previous generation. Come on, let us bow. Father God, we thank you.
Right now, we are discussing how the enemy's gifts and God's gifts are being manifested in the youth's lives, and so they're discussing with one another certain struggles and things that they may be dealing with that basically demonstrate weakness, bad judgment, hate that they may be demonstrating in their lives, and then also like how they are seeing God's gifts being manifested, so power, love, and self-discipline.
So how is power manifested in your life?
Power.
Power comes from a lot of stuff. Power for me, it comes from happiness. Because when I'm happy, I feel like I can do a lot. Like music and art, that make me happy. Football, it make me happy.
So using the gifts that God has given you makes you happy.
Yeah.
We think it's the hardest thing in the world, but he can carry those burdens for us. And also, I think it's strength because he allows us to have strength to continue on with day-to-day situations.
We see those things all the time. We see the enemy's gifts quite often more than we do God's gifts. Why do you think that is?
If the enemy can't get to this person, he's going to try to find somebody that's weaker. So, like, say if he's trying to get to your parents, but he can't get to your parents because they're too, like,
first.
Yeah, so he's going to attack them. Yeah. That's how I think.
God is really waiting to see if you can get out of that situation. He's not just going to help you. He wants to see what you can do first.
Well, that's when...
It's always a test.
Okay, so like I just said, your parents, they're most, like... They're Christian based, they're doing everything, they're devoted to Christ. So they know that the devil is not gonna get to them. Then there's you you have not learned everything that they know.
You don't know as much as they do.
Yeah, so the devil's like, oh, I see a weakling, like I'm gonna go to them and I'm gonna do anything in my will to destroy them.
Yeah.
Cause like the Bible said, the devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy you.
Where's your power? Where's your weakness? What do you love most? What is something that you hate? Where does your self-discipline lie? And where does your bad judgment lie?
The exercise that we're doing right now is connecting with the power source as far as old Paul talking to young Timothy and making sure that even though Paul knew that he was about to die at the hands of the Romans, he still wanted to make sure that his calling, which was God assigned on his life, was that he would make sure that he passed the torch on to young Timothy to continue with God's mission to share the good news and to share the gospel. He didn't want to leave it in vain, and he wanted to make sure that he equipped Timothy with what he needed before he died at the hands of the Romans. And in that, he needed to find out what were the things that he loved, hated, self-discipline, bad judgment, and also love and hate choices. He needed to get to know him so that way he would teach him how to approach and how to apply it and be lit and not have a fear and be of a sound mind and not timid.
But we know who the one who is all-powerful, almighty, and all-righteous is. He is King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the Creator of heaven and earth.
Yeah.
Sometimes you want a chance to throw yourself, but you can't never put your foot in front of the other. You can't never bring your voice to where it's supposed to be. And you go home and pray that God's going to bless you with another chance to shine, and you're not willing to step to the spotlight. Give you another door and you're not trying to open it. But unless you stop doing this and start doing this, there's nothing you can ask for.
Psalm 35:22 states, cast your burdens upon the Lord and he shall sustain you. This means God cares and wants you to confide in him. As the saying goes, prayer should be the key of the day and the lock of the night.
We as high schoolers have so much power, but we limit it simply because we are scared. Being scared is perfectly human, but God did not give the spirit to you. Now friends, we all have them. The thing we fail to realize is that the same friends we lie for and die for will be the same friends God turn around and hurt us. Proverbs
2018, let's get it!
Hey!
Yo, everybody come get your bounce on, get your bounce on, get your bounce on. Don't be cute with it, you gotta get, come on. Fifth ward, fourth ward. Come on, sing it.
your enemy has issues. I said you're a giant because, but believe it or not, your enemy has issues. Let me help you. Whenever we come into battle, whenever we deal with an opposition, we often maximize the ability of our enemies and minimize the ability of our God. Verse 7 says he's led by an armor bearer or an assistant. Or maybe he needs an armor bearer and an assistant because he can't see. Can I ask you a question tonight? Are you still afraid of the light? Are you still trembling in your proverbial shoes because of the description that's given to him? See, here's the thing. Everybody celebrates David, but you got to know David had to go this way. That David couldn't opt out of this battle. Not because he needed to know who he was. He already knew. Because there was a nation on the mountainside that was watching him in the battle. They didn't have the guts to fight Goliath. He did. What better way to foster confidence in the people you're getting ready to lead than to face an enemy they're scared of? You know why? There's some battles you can't get out of. You want to know why there's some battles that you can't escape from? You've been praying, God, get me out of this. And God said, no. You got to stay in this.
You got to stay.
Because there's some people watching you who need to know who I am. They won't see it. Until I get finished with you. Gotta go. All I can tell you is, while you're calling your giant the giant, you're more of a giant than you could ever imagine. You are bigger. You are stronger. You got more power than you could ever imagine. How do you know you're the giant? Giants are the ones who get up after the battle.
Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah.
That's all right.
Every giant doesn't look like a giant. But when the battle is over, it's the giant that's still standing. That's why some of you got a testimony, even as a teenager. Some of you got a worship and you got a connection to God that people don't understand because you know what people have tried to do to you. You know what your own society and culture says about you. Many of you even know what your own family says about you.
Help us.
They don't expect you to make it. They don't expect you to survive. They don't expect you to overcome. But you are stronger, you are greater, you are bigger than they can estimate. And you're even greater than you can estimate. But what you believe about yourself will always dictate what the rest of your future looks like. I'm done. I know. If you lifted your hand tonight for salvation, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to step on the stage with me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Come on. We just want to be identified. Come on. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Come on. Come on. Hallelujah. Amen. Stretch your hands this way to those who came tonight. Father, in the name of Jesus, you know what they need. You know what they stand in need of. God, seal it in the name of Jesus, that they will embrace you and confess you by faith and say yes to a saving relationship with Jesus Christ. God, allow those mentors, those chaperones, and those church families around them to cover them, to keep them, to stand with them, to let them know they're not on this walk by themselves. That you got plans for their lives. You got people around them who are rooting them on. People around them who want them to succeed. People around them who see the giants in them that they don't even see yet. God, I pray in the name of Jesus, you'll show them who they are and show them who you are. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Say, God. Come on, talk to him. Say, God. I love you.
I love you.
I believe.
With all of my heart,
that you love me.
It's some stuff
that I may have done. As a matter of fact,
it's some stuff
that I have done.
But right now,
God, because you love me,
I ask
that you forgive me
of my sin.
Now, God, because I believe in you,
I'm believing
that you're forgiving me
right now.
Say, I believe
with all my heart
that Jesus Christ
is Lord.
I believe
with all my heart
that Jesus Christ
is your son.
God,
I believe
with all of my heart
that your son,
Jesus Christ,
died for my sins.
And he arose
from the grave
just for me.
I believe this
in my heart.
And now
I confess it
with my mouth.
And because your word says so,
I'm saved.
Say it again. Say, I'm saved.
I'm saved.
Say it like you know it. Say, I'm saved.
I'm saved.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Come on, bless God right now. Come on, watch and be saved. We're going to be all over this place.
What you do, and the honor of you from around the world, from the depth the streets of the mountaintop. We have 39 youth and we have 14 also chaperones that come up and help us with this event. So thank you again.
Come on, y'all give it up for all of our groups, all of our groups. Amen.
In third place, we have Pay Dance Demo. In second place, we have Gala Terry.
It's my life. Hallelujah.